What do you do if you are using Kajabi and you go into your people area just to check that you are able to email everyone and you see this never subscribed, or you see someone who is marked as unsubscribed and they didn't want to be? I'm going to go through two ways that you can quickly and easily fix this up, as unfortunately there's no way to just manually go in and check subscribed due to email marketing regulations. You do need to have permission to email someone through a bulk emailing service, and that is why you can't just go in and play around and find some setting to turn on. You've actually got to do a little bit of a manual workaround. But just quickly, I will show you how this even happens in the first place. So there's two reasons that this happens. First reason is if you go to add a contact, either through a CSV or adding in a single contact, maybe you've got people that have subscribed on another website or have just manually asked you to go onto your newsletter, you add in their details and you do not check this box, subscribe to marketing emails. If you don't check the box, subscribe to marketing emails, unfortunately, they are going to show up as never subscribed. So please do be careful when you are importing people into your people list, A, that you've got permission to email them, and B, that you are noting that down. The second reason is if you are selling a product and in the product settings in the checkout, there's a little box that says subscribe to emails and someone doesn't click on that. If they don't click on that, they're going to show up in your people area as never subscribed, and you are not going to be able to send them any marketing emails. You can send transactional emails, that's a different story, and you can do that through your products and announcements if you have a product. So if you don't have a product, you might be like, well, that's not going to help me, I can't email them. So just as an aside, the settings area to set it up on your checkout so that you do get people who are clicking on that subscribe to emails, coming to your settings under your checkout settings, and just make sure that you are adjusting that to make it a little bit more appealing rather than just saying subscribe to our email list. You actually give people a reason and you give them some kind of phrasing that makes them know it's important for them to click that option. You can actually automatically sign up people when they purchase a paid offer. I would recommend, in order to comply with email marketing laws and regulations, that you let people know what is going on, make it part of the terms and conditions box that they check that they will be subscribing to your list and they can unsubscribe at any time. Don't just add them to your list, because people sometimes can get a little bit funny about that. But yeah, just come in here to this option if you do find that you're getting problems with people who are showing up as never subscribed after a purchase. All right, so that's the situations that can make it happen, but how do you fix it? And how do you fix it if someone's unsubscribed by accident and they've asked you to add them back in and you don't want to have the hassle of saying, oh, please go and sign up for this thing again? So first option, pretty simple, kind of scary, but simple, is simply delete the contact and re-import them. I'd only suggest to do that if you have added them in manually and it has come across as never subscribed. Because when you do delete someone, you delete all of their history. So if they have purchased a product, you'll delete that transaction, their access will cease, etc. So you don't want to do it for someone who's purchased, just if you have done this importing and forgot to check subscribe. So if that's the case, you just come into the people, click on all the people, press delete. It is going to ask you to write delete so you don't accidentally do that, because deleting is a little bit problematic. Everything's gone. But yeah, it's the easiest way to do it if you've just imported them, but especially because you can do bulk people at once. And then you can either re-import the CV or the single contact, and we will we'll come here. Sue.com. Please make sure to subscribe to marketing emails. Once you check that, it will be all good. And when we import this time, it is going to show up as subscribed. So that works if there's no history and there's nothing that you're worried about deleting. It's the quickest and easiest way to get someone back in. And when we go into people, you will see that we have in here and subscribed. So the other way to do it, if you don't want to be deleting people, if that feels a little bit scary, is to go and create a form. So I've got one that I've created earlier, but I'm going to show you from scratch. So you can call this something that's going to mean something to you, so you know that this is the right form. So we're going to call this manually adding clients to email list. So say you do have a client. Like, one of the things I always suggest is if you have any kind of one-on-one booking form where you're getting people to book on a calendar and you have questions, I always say, would you like to join the email list? And you know, probably get 50 people a year joining our email list just from doing that, and then we have to go and add them in manually. So yeah, having a form like that is handy for more than one reason. So in this one, we just want a single opt-in. We don't want to have a double opt-in. You might want to do that if there was you know, other reasons. Not going to go into that today. Single double opt-in is a whole video on its own. So single opt-in, a title that you will remember. That makes sense. We do not need to worry about any of these other things because we're manually doing it. First name and email is enough. Now, if you wanted, you can add automations like sending them an email or anything like that. But this one is just simple. We're just simply adding them in the list. They don't even need to know this is all going on. We're going to fix it all up for them. So we don't need to worry about automations. We're going to save it, and we're going to do one other little thing, and then I'm going to show you how you can easily access this form. We're going to click onto embed, and we're just going to make a little update. So instead of saying join the newsletter, we are going to say manually add to email list. I'm just putting this in if it was a team. Clients to email list so they can get our marketing emails. Subscribe. So you can, you know, fancy that up if you want. You don't have to. No one's going to see this. This is only for you. So, you know, it's up to you how much you want to fancy it. I think just at least don't have it so it's join the newsletter. So you're like, huh, is that the right one? All right. So then we're going to go into our form details. Back to form details. This should be saved. Hopefully I pressed save. I'm pretty sure I did. We're going to click on preview, and this is going to open this up for us as a form, like a website page, except this is where you manually add clients. What you need to do, copy this URL and save it somewhere. So for example, we have this one saved, everyone in our team, this internal Facebook form ad. So we've actually put this one on a page because we've got a couple of forms that we're just keeping all together in one place. But if you've just got one form, just go to the form, press preview, and then come in here and put that person's name in. So we're going to do this test, and what should we make this? I need a new email address. Thank you, we've received your submission, and we're going to come back in here. If I haven't already put this on here as a testing email address, that's my personal email address where I send all my spam. There we go, in there, subscribed. And if we actually go in there, we can go back to the form and see the form. We could even add a tag, manual add, or something like that if we wanted to, where it will say opted into manually adding clients to email list. And we can see there, subscribed. And if we wanted to unsubscribe them, that's what we could click. But if they're unsubscribed, their option will not be there. So that is how you do it. Creating a form, just go back over that one more time. So either deleting and re-adding them in manually, or creating a form on the page and then previewing that form, which will take you to the URL or the website link for that page, so that someone can then go and click on that and add themselves, or you can click on that and add them to the email list. Any questions, please do let me know.